Now I'm going to introduce you what you're going to learn in this semester in the context of this course. So the name of this course is Molecular Biology in Conservation. So you have learned a little bit of molecular biology in another course, the Biology, Cells and Genetics, some of the basic over the past 2 years. And you learn quite a lot about the conservation over the past 2 years. So the conservation in this context is conservation biology. So what is a conservation biology? So this is a definition you can find in Wikipedia. So it's a scientific study of the nature and status of Earth biodiversity with the aim to protect species, their habitat and ecosystem from excessive rate of extinction and erosion of biotic interaction. Okay, so there are a few keywords: species, habitat, and ecosystem. So this is a definition, but what is the objective of the conservation biology? So based on the definition, does it mean that we have to protect everything and we cannot use any natural resource for our daily use? So does it mean to conserve every species and habitat on the earth? Of course, this is unrealistic and it's impossible. Okay. We still need the resource from the ecosystem and the species. Okay. So what is need to do, we have to measure the way that we consume the natural resource is sustainable. So they should be part of the resource that can be used by human, and they are part of the resource that need to be protected. So the key word here is the prioritization. Okay, you have to choose which one you want to protect and which one you want to use. You can consume. So if you are a conservation biologist, so what is your job duty? So your job duty is to advise decision and policy makers, and you need to base on science all the suggestion. Okay. So just look at this scenario. So what you see here is a map of Peninsula Malaysia, and all the dots that you see on the map are the limestone hills. Okay, for example, this 1, 2, 3 is a limestone hill, and you can see now this tree hill are in different environmental habitat condition. For example, this one, you still have a pristine forest, and these two already have been damaged. So remember, you have to choose which one you want to conserve. So now, based on this information, which hill that you think is that you want to conserve and choose? So think about it for 10 seconds. You can make any decision, but the decision that you make is very hard to justify because you don't have other information. So the quality of the decision making is depend on the state of the knowledge for the habitat and also the species. So just now we have the information for the habitat. We know that one of the hill, the forest is still intact. The other two hills, the forest have been damaged. But we don't have any information about the species. So the knowledge is from information and the information is from the data. So the data for every aspect of the species and habitat is very important. For example, you need the data for the taxonomy. You need to know what are the species there. You need the data about the distribution. Where are those species can be found? Are there any endemic species? You also need to know about their ecology, the phylogenetic, and also the evolution. So in order to get all this data, you need the skill and tools. For example, for taxonomy, you really need a skill for the database management. For distribution, you need a GIS skill. For ecology, you need to use a lot of the statistics and also use a lot of the ecological method. For phylogenetic and evolution, you need to collect a lot of the, you need to use some molecular biology tools to collect the data. So that's the reason why you have a course that teach you about the database management, a course that teach you the GIS, and also the course that teach you the statistics and also ecological method. So what we are going to do in this semester is to help you to acquire the skill for the, in the molecular biology, so that you can also collect the data from the in terms of the phylogenetic and also the evolution. So the final goal is to help you to make a good decision. So just now we discussed about conservation, now we look at the molecular biology. So the molecular biology in this context is referred to the molecular biology techniques. So the molecular biology techniques are the methods used in biological study at molecular level, okay, which involve isolation, characterization, analysis of RNA, DNA, protein, and other molecule. Okay. So why do we know about the genetic information? Okay. So in this course, we will not touch the protein and other molecule. Okay. Because you have learned this in other subject. And we also will not discuss a lot about the RNA, but we'll discuss more on the DNA. Okay. So the DNA and RNA actually is a genetic information. So we know that we have to look from two aspects when we talk about conservation, which one is a habitat, another one is species, the habitat diversity and also the species diversity. Okay. So the species diversity actually is reflect the morphological diversity, which is related to the functional diversity. Okay. And also similar to the concept of phylogenetic diversity. So we go back to the scenario just now. So now you have more information. In addition to the habitat condition, we also have a biodiversity, the species information. So now in this hill you have one species, this hill you have another species, but this hill you have two species. So now you can, if you need to make a decision to advise a policy maker and decision maker, which hill that you will suggest to the policy maker to be protected? A, B, or C? Think about it for a few seconds. So you might say B, right? Okay? It's more likely your answer will be B, because for each of these hills, you have one species, and each of them have their individual species, and these two species are different. But for this hill, even though the half of the hill have been destroyed, but you have both species occur in one hill. So that means that if you can choose one hill, if you choose this one, you save two species. In this case, you can save either one of the two species that know to be occur in that area. So this is a 6-second scenario. Okay, the same hills, but now you have all the hill have the same species. So which hill that you will be choose? So which two hill that you want to choose? Let's say in this case you choose two hill instead of one. So it's still very hard for you to make decision. So of course you want to maximize, first you want to maximize the species diversity. Okay. So in the previous case, save one hill in at the same time, you will save two species. So you try to maximize the number of the species, the species diversity that you can protect. So in this case, each of the hill have one species, the same species, and you need to choose two of the hill. So the number of the species is the same, the species diversity is the same. But if possible, we want to conserve as much phylogenetic diversity as possible. That means that the two population have more difference, okay, more variable in their genetic. So in this case, you have A, B, C, and this is the phylogenetic result. So this is what we call the phylogenetic tree, this one. Okay. So if two species or two population or two individual, when you get the genetic data, the DNA data, then you can use the DNA data, the ATCG, the sequence, to reconstruct the tree. So the species with more similar genetic composition, the DNA sequence, will be grouped together. The one that is more different will be fall outside of the clade, okay, a cluster. So in this case, in order to maximize the genetic diversity, you will choose the B, because B is very different from A and C, and after that, because you need to choose two, right, you will choose either A or C. So in this case, I will choose C, okay, taking into the consideration of the species diversity, the genetic diversity, and also the quality of the habitat. Okay, instead of choosing this, this is better. Okay, the habitat is more intact, which will means it's more probably the species will survive in this kind of the habitat compared to this. So the scope of the course is mostly DNA and a little bit of RNA. Okay, for the other, for protein and other molecules, you already learn this in other course. So if you search in the literature database, Web of Science or Scopus or Google Scholar or just Google, okay, and then we look at the top 10 journal in the field of biodiversity and conservation, and we look at the articles they published between this year, so there are more than 7,000 articles. Okay. So out of the 7,000 articles, 10% of them use the genetic tools. Okay, so that means that they use the genetic tools to explore, describe, or even solve the biodiversity and conservation problem or issue. Okay, out of the 10%, so out of this 10% of this article, about half of them using they collect the genetic data and they analyze it by using the phylogenetic approach. And another 30%, one third of it, they use the population genetic approach. Okay, study the genetic diversity between population, okay, or within the population. So this will be taught in other course, which is also in this semester, the genetic conservation. So for this course, we're going to talk more about the phylogenetic approach, how we can use the genetic data to reconstruct the phylogenetic relationship, the phylogenetic tree that I showed you just now, and after that, do further analysis and interpretation based on the tree, and hopefully you can use the information to translate it into, then put into your context, your conservation problem, and hopefully you can formulate a knowledge to solve the biodiversity and conservation issue. So for these two approach, the lab technique is very similar. Okay. So first you isolate the genetic material, the DNA or RNA, then you amplify for target specific genetic marker, because the genome is very large, so it's quite expensive to study the whole genome, so you only study part of the genome. And also the DNA sequencing technique. So the differences between these two approaches, it's mainly in the experiment design, the type of the research question that you ask, the data analysis, and also the application. So in this course, you can divide into four different parts. So first, in the first few weeks, you will learn about the molecular technique. So it's really on the lab techniques, including the concept, theory, and also the practical. And the second part of the course, you're going to learn more of the different type of the genetic marker, the part of the genome that you're going to use to study the phylogenetic relationship. after you learn how to collect or obtain the DNA sequence, you know the theory about the DNA sequence, you're going to use the sequence to reconstruct the phylogenetic tree. Then, so you're going to learn a few data analysis, okay, mainly for the phylogenetic reconstruction to make the tree. After that, you're going to learn more about the application, how you can apply, use this information, this data, in the conservation biology.